you know this guy, and did you go to school here? 2 days ago, she responds. So this is like a year and a half later. You know, she responded. She's like, well,
let me take him to 68.
Ooh, nice. Thank you.
Well, that's so we've been kind of talking back and forth a little bit, just catching up. She's got a couple of arrows of her own, and ironically, she is a
middle school.
I'm getting ready.
Okay.
History teacher. You know what I mean? And I said, I'm like, you do that so funny. Like almost every person.
Made me 48, pushing 49.
Yeah, last 6 years.
So, you know, I when I was in high school, so I had some really close friends in junior high school. And of course, then the four of us went to three different schools for high school. And the one friend that was my friend from junior high that I went to the same school with, he was one of those, you know, tall, good-looking, chiseled jaw, jock guys, hung out with the cheerleaders and had his little clique. And that was not me.
Right.
So we kind of sort of in high school. So really, I did my schoolwork, did my JRTC, and right. So it's like, why would I go back to see a bunch of people that I have had no contact with for 30 years?
That's kind of how I am. At our 20th, everybody, there's only about four people from my life that I care to talk to. I mean, we played soccer.
Well, but that's just it. If you
care when I talk to them,
exactly.
You've been talking to them for 20 years. You know everything. You don't need to go to catch up.
Yeah.
Yes. Well, I got a letter that said, hey, you know, come to our 20th level, you know, catch up or whatever. I don't need to catch up. I responded. I said, I don't need to catch up. Everybody I care to talk to, I still do. Yeah. I can tell you all about them.
Was so what's really funny is what really turned me off from this reunion. So the guys that I ended up being close for the guys I was in JRTC with, because we view outside stuff
right.
All the time. And over the years, I mean, these guys figured, you know, JRTC guys are probably pretty conservative guys. These guys left the reservation.
Right.
This one dude, you know, one time I posted on Facebook that I was driving cross country when we were moving out here. And he goes, hey, so you're going to be going through Iowa, stop by Iowa City and come see me. I'm like, sorry, you can't afford the time. But we connected on Facebook and he friended me and I accepted. And then,
all right, so when it's my turn for comments, the first thing I want to do is talk about the students.
Right.
Each other out with. And I just want to share with the community. Hey, listen, you know, we always hear the negative things about what this person's doing about us, you know, but something happened today. I just wanted to give Dr. Schmidt some props about his presentation. And
sure.
He was, you know, geared up, ready to go. And when the senator said, hey, so what's the fix?
Right. He had an answer.
There it was. You know what I mean? It was delivered efficiently, professionally.
Mm-hmm.
It's logical. I mean, it makes sense. You know what I mean? Like, it wasn't like, hey, let me just pull this up kind of out of thin air. No, it was. So
my neighbor was going to attend, but she has a severe allergic reaction to bleach. She walked into the building, smelled bleach, and said, I can't come in.
Oh, no. So anyways, that's
cool. I mean, in the order, I'm going to call out.
Oh, I don't care. You send me first, man. I don't care. That way nobody can steal my
No, window. But if you have a good positive message, maybe you should go last. Because we always want to end on a good note, right?
Right.
Okay.
I just don't want anybody to steal my thunder.
I'm not. I doubt Mac will. I really doubt Mike will. Just add it. Oh, come on. If she can get a text in, why can't I get a text out?
So, this live stream is going to start now.
Okay. Hey, live stream, huh? Hot mic.
Okay, the phone didn't work.
No? Okay. I was hoping it would work plugging in there. Okay, but we can go wireless. I'll try to use my phone then. I get pretty good service in here, or we can try it with Tamper first.
Okay. We have the internet part, and these baffle me sometimes making them work, so that's why I'm making the comment. I just plugged this in. I don't have the internet.
And that one's okay. So, is this a regular phone?
So
that's Ethernet line.
That's how they hook it up, though.
Right. What it is, this is if you want to then plug it into a computer.
Okay. So I do have it. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's okay.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ken.
Kitchen update. Very detailed. I love details.
I can't remember what I put in.
Hi. How are you?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing well.
I just need
So we can
but it's going to take 6 weeks.
Right. I had a little something about a month ago, for a couple days.
So I can't legally take my truck onto I-65.
She was saying that you were home, Christine was saying you were home.
But if the church is like,
We went, you know, the commercial, the guy's sick, he wants candle soup, and the lady says, call your mother. We was like, I was like, so does he want soup?
I can take it as a donation.
And she goes, yeah, I told him. Really? Wow. Can't argue with direction like that, right? Cool.
Because I have to say but it's just a moment, so they don't have to wait until this community.
We can try campers. We tried it and didn't work.
That's a voice over IP port. All
right.
I
have a service. Okay.
Well, that's an idea that's like specific. Look, he's already asking for it.
Thank you, my loving daughter.
So Hanover School District 28 is our channel. Yeah, it has about a 20-second delay, so I'm already over here by the camera looking at the screen. That's why I disappeared. So there you have it.
Yes, we're back up. We got the capability.
So I'll give you the phone over to Randy.
They were charged. No, we're charged.
I'm going to push you on speaker so you know that right now.
Okay. I don't want to tag the glasses. That's not going to be all. That's not much.
Hey, you're the man.
Hey, you're the man.
Hey, can you guys? What's the delay like?
Can you guys hear him on the microphone from the speakers?
Okay.
So give me a sound check back. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Happy birthday, Mike.
Hold on, I want to make the mic to sit down. Give me a mic, give me a sound check. Okay. Give it to me back. You can hear Mike?
Yep.
Okay. Part 2.
the September payables and staff recommendations are not available to Beth. Do I have any other modifications to the agenda? Hearing none, okay, call for the vote, please.
Mr. Allen?
Aye.
Well, can I have a motion?
Oh, all right.
I'm sorry to approve you.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Now, call for the vote, please. I'm still rusty at this. I'll get better.
Okay, Mr. Allen?
Aye.
Mr. Lawson?
Aye.
Mr. Pearson? Matt?
Oh, I'm sorry, that was a call fail.
Drive.
I think she has warm still.
So you want to take that?
Mr. Swayze?
Aye.
Mr. Underwood?
Aye. Okay, student performances, only seeing one student, or two, there's two, woo. I'm assuming there are no student performances. So I guess that brings us to open forum. I'm assuming we have people signed up to speak.
The first one is Chandra Vigil.
Ms. Vigil, good evening. I can't speak for the rest of them, but I'm fabulous.
I'm coming to ask the board.
Can you grab the microphone, please?
I'm coming to ask the board if you guys can implement some kind of policy that is okay for the staff or the superiors of Hanover Junior Senior High School to be able to step up to an adult and say, I'm sorry, you don't look good. I'm sorry, it's not acceptable to walk into the school in a bra. I'm talking about Miranda Christensen. She walked into
Can
the...
Can you just please refrain from calling out individuals?
Sorry. She walked into the school for the high school volleyball tournament wearing a sports bra. That is not appropriate. I mean, my shirt technically would not be appropriate in my terms for the school. You know, but at the same time, the dress code, when did society as a whole become so scared to be able to step up and say, as an adult to another adult, I'm sorry, but this is not appropriate for our students to be looking at. If we want them to follow a strict dress code policy, the parents and the people that attend this school should as well.
I don't necessarily disagree with you. I do think that, and I think I was talking to Mr. Swayze about this. There are potential certain legalities of, you know, we're having a public event, you know, we're having a volleyball tournament. Technically, it's a public event on public property. You know, I would have to, we would have to investigate the legalities of that. But personally, I'm with you.
Okay. That's all I asked.
So we will, we'll look into that and we'll get some kind of an answer back to you as soon as we can.
Okay.
Sure, go for it.
And by the way, I want you to know that the whole board agrees with you on that.
I can't speak for the whole board, but.
Well, no, every one of us is talking about it. We don't.
I don't
believe that should happen.
Next.
Charity Garrett.
Ms. Garrett, good evening.
Good evening.
Bye, Nick.
Bye, Nick.
See ya. Thank you for your service, bro.
Can you move the crooked parked car?
Okay, so this evening I wanted to address the issue of bullying because I was approached Sunday by someone who was a mentor to some of the...
Did you say Sunday?
I was approached on Sunday by somebody that was a mentor of some of the high school students that had expressed how upset he was about the bullying that's going on at the high school. And he informed me that the complaints of the students are going ignored. He also said that certain members of the board had responded in a negative way when they were informed about the bullying. So he wanted to involve the news. And I want to know that that happened. So some parents got the news together and they called me and asked me to come talk to them. But nothing ever came of it. But most of you probably know. I'm sure Underwood and Pearson know about it. You don't know. It was a given day in 2014, 2015 school year.
Oh, and I'm probably aware of it. I just don't know specifically.
Well, anyway, so it was just obvious to me that the issue is ongoing. Obviously, it's never been resolved. So, and it's really kind of ironic because I just sent an email to administration, counselor, and a teacher last week about this very thing because Sarah was being bullied by a girl. And I originally talked to the counselor, and she had to talk with the girls and hoping that we could resolve it and all that, but it still continued. And I told Sarah, talk to your teacher. Leave it alone, let her know, because obviously the teacher might not be aware of it, and so Sarah did. And the teacher told Sarah not to worry about it, didn't reprimand the girl that had bullied her. And so, what do we do? You know, these kids, this bully, I feel worse for the bullies because they're the ones that they need to learn social skills. And when they're not being reprimanded, then this little girl is gonna go and, you know, be all poor Boulder about picking on Sarah because she was not reprimanded for it. And I was told by administration when I talked to the principal in the past, that every time that there is a bully situation, it is handled according to policy. She swore to me that the stuff that I was hearing was gossip, that kids were telling lies, exaggerating. But I cannot completely rely on that because of what I experienced myself just last week because I saw it happening with my own child. And then I have somebody coming to me, expressing to me his concerns. I was thinking he was going to show up tonight, but he's not here. But he wanted to express his concerns. But that is my biggest thing I want to talk about tonight because it needs to be fixed. Because it's not fair to Sarah. She can't get her work done when she has kids doing that to her. And I personally never really experienced it before because
you probably can't read that in there, but that's one of my notes for comments.
Is it? Well, see, Rebecca, it really depends on the kid's personality because I wouldn't have experienced that with Rebecca. And if that had happened to Rebecca, I probably would have got a phone call right away because it would have erupted into the new thing and everybody would have known about it. Whereas Sarah is just, she's shy, she keeps to herself, and she doesn't say anything, and it's not fair. There's so many kids like that that you guys don't hear about it because they keep it in. And the teachers see it going on. I know they do, and they don't do anything about it. And whenever it's in your policy that these teachers are educated on how to handle this, and they're not handling it appropriately.
You're like, did you read my notes?
No.
That's basically the message that I was going to say.
So
I'm sorry, I can interrupt again. Did you said you sent an email last week. Did you get a response from that email?
I got a brief response from, I think I got one from you, Grant.
Okay.
But no, I didn't receive a response from anybody else yet. And that's one of the issues that I want to address too, is that I think that's something that you guys need to sit down and talk about. What's an appropriate time frame for the board, for administration, and the teachers to be getting back?
We actually recently had that conversation.
Because I do have two emails that, you know, it's been a couple of weeks, I still haven't received a response from. And then the other thing is that the issue I brought up last month about the physical activities. I understand that's still not happening.
Well,
so
it would take more than a month for us to assess where we are with compliance and implement any kind of change. But it's definitely on our radar. We, again, we board members have a amongst us discuss that. I had a conversation, very lengthy conversation with the superintendent about it. And so, yeah, it's definitely on our radar. We not ignore it.
Right, yeah, I want to see that happen as soon as possible because I know it's going to make a difference in a lot of parents. And the other thing that, you know, wanted to talk about was the teachers, you know, not, they're still not enforcing, and something was one of the domain role that McPherson said last meeting emailed to the administration about test anxiety relating exercises. That's not being done. And the other thing that concerned me when I was going through the test that she had done on the grade was that there's no feedback. And that they need to be receiving feedback. When they take a test and they
have
the teacher
marks,
there's no feedback. The teacher marks it wrong, they need to like, this is why it's wrong. Or this is the right answer so the kid can see what they did wrong and improve.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so that was my concern. And I don't know if there was a policy in place. I didn't see it. Maybe you guys can email me if there is on a time frame that teachers have to grade work.
I don't know. I'm not aware of any policy.
We have a policy around eligibility. And so it's not written in policy, but it's understood by staff. It needs to be graded every week before the next eligibility list is pulled so we stay up to date.
Right.
So that would then apply for 40 weeks and have 4 days for this change. Items that are graded back, or at least show up in a grade book for the students.
Right, because I would think at least once they take one test, prior to taking another test, they should have the feedback from the first test. And that can go on. And that's what had me concerned, is because, you know, the one test she had gone through and had not noticed which was synonyms to antonyms when answering the question. And she did it on the second test. But if she had gotten her graded feedback earlier, then she would have known to watch for that on her next test. So I think that's something that's important that they do is provide them feedback. And
that's fair.
So
yeah. I mean, I know one teacher in particular that's really good with feedback.
Right.
So, you know, I mean, it is.
Yeah, it's possibly, it probably varies between the teachers, but from what I've seen with Sarah so far, that's, I'm not seeing that, and it really should be done because we want to improve their performance, and
I don't know
that's
how much
something I'm going to do.
Yeah, I don't know as a board how much we can affect that.
That's more about operational, but the example that she's giving, she shared about the test is that her daughter took a test, didn't do well, and they will take it again. But again, we didn't have any feedback before.
No, it wasn't taken. They were only taken one time.
I just thought
that when she graded the papers that she should put feedback on the papers if you're going to mark the answer wrong. Yeah.
So she failed some or didn't do well on another one, right? Right after?
Both of them, she didn't do well on
the
about how the practice is going to be.
We're just now approved tonight. That's part of the package.
So you're 2 months from now.
And we're 2 months behind. Well, she's got 10 days. She's got 2 months from today. Yeah,
when you look at the agenda, it says approved the August 17, 2016 regular board minutes. I can't post them on the website until after they have their meeting tonight and approve them.
That's what I mean. Why is it takes so long? I don't understand.
The minutes have to be approved by the board. The minutes from the last meeting, and when we only have a meeting once a month, that's when they get approved.
So you're always going to be 2 months behind.
Well, I'm looking online,
and I'm trying to read something, and it says July, and I'm trying to look at what was said in the last month's deal. I can't do it. So that can't come to this meeting prepared for this month.
Is the voice not already online?
The voice is on there.
So you can listen to the entire last month's meeting.
Okay, then I'll have to look at that.
The recording's on.
I was looking for the written part.
The written part cannot be put on, cannot be put online until the board approves them. We just did it tonight, so technically I'm only 1 month behind because there are no minutes except for what's happened up to this moment.
Well, this is something I wanted to talk about. I brought this up before. It has to do with fighting in the school. I've seen nothing change in any kind of policies. The school policy that was told to me when my daughter was involved in the fight was that, and this was by person in administration, two kids fight, both are suspended. And I think that's ridiculous. It's just because a child is at school, they don't give up their right to defend themselves. I was told this was a school policy and a state policy by this person. It is not written anywhere. I looked in the state and I've looked on the policies here. There's nothing written that says both students will be suspended. In this instance, my daughter was attacked and defended herself. She ended up being suspended because the person told me that's school policy. I can't find it. I'm talking about a situation. How can I talk about a situation if I don't say something?
Point of order, this is the presiding president.
Thank you.
In accordance with communication policy, board members are not.
Why didn't you say anything to me when I was talking about my daughter?
I did warn Ms. Vigil to not drop names, so let's. Can we just talk? If you have a problem with a policy of both students fighting,
I'll skip that. I'll be happy to skip that.
Okay, so we understand that. You have a problem with the. Written policy.
That's right.
Okay.
A student, let me finish that. A student who is attacked by another should not be penalized because the teacher or persons of authority did nothing to stop it. If a student were to attack the superintendent and he defended himself, are you going to suspend him and the student? No. That's common sense. You wouldn't do that. Right? It needs to be put in the school policy and common sense should prevail. You suspend the instigator, not the defendant. Right? This is the second time I brought this up and have seen no action. And I wasn't even contacted to tell me what was going on. I said, also, I contacted a member of this board who is not here tonight and on a subject and was not responded to for 2 weeks. Then was told, I don't check this email very often, but get in touch with me, and never did. This happens with teachers and staffs and board members, and why? I would like to know what the board's definition is for a reasonable time for board members, staff members, and teachers to respond when a parent calls the school or sends an email.
I think I think you know, the answer is it's very different between a teacher, the administration, and the board. So I don't think I can just give you a number for that will cover all situations. But I mean, there is a common sense level of courtesy that needs to be invoked in the timeliness of responses. I agree.
On the discipline, I know that we've just gone through JKE. I was looking for a date on there. I don't see a date. If we can get a date put on the actual exhibit, the one we revised or put it on.
We'll talk about that.
He brought it up in his comments. So I know we just approved that one, not more than 1 month ago, for the second reading. Mm-hmm. So we have taken actions and we have done stuff to try to mitigate what we're talking about. The policies have been changed. The exhibit did come out. The regulation, I believe you were working on the regulation. I looked at the data. It hasn't been done yet, but I believe it's in the process of being looked at. Because the last time that I see it was 2013. And we just now have a new JKE out, which is a new exhibit. So I know Dr. Schmidt said he was going to be working on the regulation to get it brought up.
So I can tell you this, because everyone knows my opinion of the new discipline exhibit. But I don't know of anywhere where it is written that is a policy to suspend full students. May be a de facto policy, but I don't believe it to be written anywhere. I also believe that the new discipline exhibit would allow for the proper adjudication. It is flexible enough that I believe it would allow for the proper adjudication of a scenario like that. Now, whether or not it's being implemented that way, you know, I don't know, but again, it's fairly new and we're still working out the kinks. How about that?
It is, but if somebody had contacted me letting me know that something was happening, I wouldn't be standing here.
Well, I mean, we approved JKE. In August, we brought it up and talked about it in July. If you look in the July minutes, or.
But I have sent emails to people, I have stood up here in front of the board. I was asked a question. I think I'm allowed to respond. If you don't mind.
Sorry about that.
So.
Oh, that was in.
Yeah, that's Conway. That was in the principal's update.
We need a, we're waiting on our picture so we can post it on the webpage. So. State of the district video, I was waiting for assessment data to be actually released, and the embargo was lifted yesterday on the growth data. So I will be finishing up that state of the district video to be posted probably on Tuesday of next week. The state of the district video will talk about each of the departments, give us some data on that, and let you know how we're doing with student achievements and some other things. We received a note board from the Paul Chisholm family. I think these are subtleties, so I brought this here for you guys. Our enrollment is fluctuating a little bit over the last 2 weeks. Some kids are moving out, some are moving in, as you typically expect. Our funded enrollment count continues to be somewhere between 242 and 244, but our budget this year is built on 240 kids. So as long as we're above 240, we're happy, right? If we're coming below 240, we'll have to start looking at making some adjustments in our budget. We had an opportunity, a group of board members and I, to meet with Steve Durham, president of the State Board of Education. He came out from junior senior high school. And visiting with him, he is one of four Republicans on the seven-member board. So it's a 4-3 in terms of political lines. And we were able to share some of our concerns, who we are as Hanover, things that would help us as they make rules. So what happens is in the legislative process, a bill comes through, it passes, and then if it deals with education, then it goes to the State Board of Education to make the rules. Here's how we're gonna make this happen. And so he left guaranteeing that each time they have a rulemaking meeting, if there's something on the agenda, that the board or I would like to let him know how it would impact us or what we recommend. He said he would take it, and he can't necessarily make it happen, but he will share it in the meeting or ask the question in the meeting. So I think that was beneficial for us to make that connection with him. He lives here in Colorado Springs. We had an opportunity to meet with Senator Kevin Grantham today. Actually, all of us in the room, we spent a lot of time together today. All of us in the room were there, and he was actually a genuine person. I didn't see politician written all over him. He actually was real genuine, understood our cause, our concerns, and I like the fact he asked us if we had any solutions. We had a good conversation around that, and the solution we're talking about is school finance. What the state can do around school finance to help districts like ourselves. So thank you. We'll represent it. Then we have an upcoming meeting in October with Representative Paul Lundeen, and then we will have to get our trifecta of political figures that represent our area. And you know, the great thing about this is that right now, when they hear Hanover, we're a name on a piece of paper somewhere. But now they've met us, when they see Hanover, what I want and I'm hoping will happen, their mental image will be our faces. And so we humanize the name. And that, you know, they'll make choices slightly different when we humanize the name versus seeing our newspaper. Our state assessment data on achievement, two-thirds of the tests that our kids take from grades 3 through high school, we went up to achievement. And so that's really good, two-thirds of that growing. And then on the growth, they also did not only do achievement, they did growth. How well did your kids grow in a given year? And if you saw the Gazette this morning, an article is in there that for English language arts, we were the second highest growth in all of the Pikes Peak region. That's counting Academy, that's counting Cheyenne Mountain, that's counting District 11, Mountain, and Whitefield. So the only people would be, the only district would be this with Edison. So actually, to a degree, we were representing the school districts. The performance framework is our report card. That's supposed to come out, they said, before the end of September to the districts, and then announced to the whole community in October. And that's how they grade us, and they accredit our school. So as soon as we get that, we'll make that known. Last year, we had a list of some things that we wanted to purchase internally. I say we, not board, and I didn't see how it is, but internally with the name team. And on that list of things to purchase was to have two buildings of some sort, one that could serve as concessions and a ticket booth out by the football field, and and one to store football equipment. And there are a couple reasons why. The one reason is because right now when people come in and they want concession, they have to go all the way back into the building and then come all the way back out and they miss a good portion of the event.
If there's a line, you can miss a quarter.
I know. and then also storage in the building to have football equipment stored because football equipment takes up a little more room than some other sports do. So we made the purchase of those two sheds, so if you see them, they were in total, it was less than $10,000. What's that? $6,100 total cost, so $3,000 each. And one has already been painted thanks to our principal, Danelle Vanessa Stein, and also Francesca, the custodian over the other building. They painted a nice blue with the yellow trims, and yellow school spirit. So when you come to the homecoming game Friday night, pay attention to that, and know that we'll be selling food there, you can go there and get that. Some upcoming purchases, just to inform the board, we're looking at cameras for our buses. We had an issue with some bus scenarios. We found that the cameras we currently have are not functioning properly, and so we need to do that. I already have TJ and his crew, TJ Paul, looking at possible systems and costs. There's a good chance we'll be coming to you though next meeting because it looks like we're going to spend in the teams. So just know that's coming forward. We're doing research now on that. We are also looking at maybe adding one or two surveillance camera that's in the junior senior high school. We have a couple dead spots which things commonly occur. And then also some of our cameras currently are not focus. And one camera at the high school is pointing at something that is like a wall or it's not pointing where it should be. So we'll be doing that. So we're going to be doing some of that, and that'll be less than $10,000. That'll be a small fix. And then we're also looking at some math instructional materials for Deer Prairie Heights. All the assessments that we took, math at the elementary level was the lowest one. That's the lowest point. So we're going to look at some instructional materials to help support our teachers so we can improve our math instruction. I only have two more things. I want to say thank you to Mike. Mike and I had an opportunity to meet with Charity and Dave, and we had some good conversation. And one of the things that came up were some people who were saying is that Mike was talking negatively about me or other admin in the district, and Mike cleared the air saying, you know, the last 11.5 months I haven't done that, and it's passed my lips. And so I want to thank you for helping clear it up with them. So rumor control is always a hard thing. So if you ever hear and speak to the audience outside, you guys already know, if you ever hear a rumor, something just doesn't sound right, the best thing is go to directly to the source and just find out. So if somebody says that one of the board members is saying something, the best thing to do is just contact that board member. Here's what I heard. Versus then telling others and getting the rumor spread before clarification comes out. So I would really appreciate that. And then my last thing is communication on the same line is if you ever have any questions, I put it in my monthly Hanover Buzz to contact me with any questions you have. Because I'm more than happy to meet. Charity and Dave, I've met with you guys a couple times. Some other community members have some questions. We've met with them. Everything's open. We will pull things out and let you look at stuff unless it's personnel files. And we're totally open. So please don't hesitate to do that. And then that's my report.
Very well.
Thank you, sir.
Who's the first?
Sure, yes, go for it.
Since my fellow board members are going to talk all night, I have absolutely nothing to say except for thank you.
To whom?
Well, that's an apology. For you.
Oh.
I forgot one thing for you down the line.
Oh.
One thing that we may be considering is you may remember we sold the Brown Lodge building. And the people who purchased it are coming next week, and they're going to spend about a half a week to 2 weeks, depending on how much time it takes. And they're going to take away. So we have been taking things that have been in the Brown modular and moving them into the old school because we need to go through it. And because of staff time, there's a good chance we may be posting a position seeking some temporary help to go through those things. So we can make sure we don't lose anything of value out of the old brown building, because there's history in there. There's old board minutes and things, I'm understanding, and old documents. So I may be coming to you guys with that. I guess it's kind of dependent on the October 5th count to make sure our funding is okay to be able to do that. Just so you're aware, that's something that we're considering. Awesome.
I'm not exactly sure I missed out on the first part of the presentation. On that building, you're talking about putting up for sale, or did you guys sold it?
We had to find a buyer before you guys came forward with any money.
We did?
Yeah.
Okay, because I guess this is the first time hearing about.
I let Chuck know.
Oh, he didn't know.
Yeah, and what the arrangement with Chuck was, we have it up for sale, and as soon as either you guys secure funds or get grants, you guys could be a buyer or we'll sell it.
Right.
And we had an offer come through.
We voted on it last month.
3 months ago, I think, and they were working on it. And then they came to the decision about a month later to determine if they were to really buy it. And then it came forward to the board.
Well, I wish somebody had told me that sooner, because like it changed things around and started on something else a long time ago.
Sorry, I guess it kind of goes with the theme of communication there. I thought Chuck could communicate that.
Right, well, I'll get it. I'll have a talk with him about it.
That's what you get in trouble.
Right.
That's on our agenda today. What about the ball field? We're asking permission to sell it. It's a first step, you know.
How big is that one?
Double wide, is it not?
It's a double wide, but I don't know the length. It's probably probably a 28-30 wide by 60.
Probably
28 or 30 by 60, 64
right in there. Yeah, I don't know if that'll be able to use it for something, but we're pushing for close to 10,000.
Well, if it passes, it's something that's not going to sell very much.
Right.
Like, not very much.
Right. Okay. Well,
you guys might be able to afford it.
Yeah, it's something you can talk to Chuck about.
Okay.
Any other outlines?
No.
Mr. McPherson, do you have anything?
There's been questions on why sophomores are enrolling concurrent enrollment college courses off campus. Our policy strictly says 11th and 12th grade or higher. 11th grade or higher. Our student handbook says 11th grade or higher. There should be no sophomores or qualified students to be enrolled or the district's paying money for a sophomore to be in college. I'm not saying I don't want to see it, because I do want to see it.
Right.
But our policy strictly says 11th grade or higher currently. So it's a violation of our policy to do it.
That would get
it fixed.
Yeah.
Change it, get them out of school, have the parents pay for it. I don't care. It's a violation of our policy currently. It says it in the handbook and it says it in the policy.
Thanks for bringing that up.
The other one is the transportation costs. I forgot to sell this one. This is down here. That was our very first meeting when I went ballistic on the board. When I was not on the board, was transportation. We talked about it with one of the former board members going in the fountain, picking up the kids, bringing them out. We are still currently providing transportation for college students when this handbook specifically says students will be required to provide their own transportation. The policy says the school district is not required to provide or pay for transportation. And the handbook says find your own way to school. So if we're bringing a bus into school for college, it's against policy, we need to change it. We need to stop it, we need to change the policy, I don't care which.
I'll do that too, thank you.
All right, so since Tag is gonna end on the good news story, I'll go next. So the first thing, and I'll start with good news, okay? For those of you that are unaware, for shame, but this week is homecoming week. There are lots of good activities going on. Let's see, so tomorrow night is the volleyball game, bonfire, jersey auction. Friday is the parade. I know it's a little early for most of you to get there. And then there's a tailgating party. No alcohol, don't freak out. No alcohol, tailgating party, and then the football game.
Kickoff at 7.
Saturday is a dance. I believe start time is 7. Come out and support. Okay, so, I mean, Charity's still most of my thunder in open forum, but I keep hearing complaints, not just from parents, but from the students as well, that this one is not being consistently enforced, and consequences are not being consistently applied. Now, I know the new discipline policy gives lots of leeway to the staff on how they can, what the consequences are for a particular infraction. And again, everyone knows my opinion on that, but there needs to be some kind of a guide or a training or something so that we can consistently enforce discipline. And when I say consistently, you know, there's one teacher that's really consistent, and then in the next classroom over, there may be a teacher that's not consistent, and the two of them aren't consistent. So everybody's got to be on the same page. You know, I could give you a dozen examples off the top of my head, but I'm sure nobody wants to listen to them. So, sir. And as we discussed in previous board meetings, I wholeheartedly disagree with that. A specific infraction deserves a specific consequence. I don't care if you do it in PE. This is just my opinion. Whether you do it in PE or math or whatever. That's just my opinion. And so, you know, I don't know what we can do within the confines of our current discipline matrix. But that's just an observation I hear all the time. I don't think I want to elaborate, because otherwise I'll get into examples that we don't want to talk about in public. Because then I might screw up and drop a name. I understand.
Now, I've been accused of making it personal.